Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. In this video I will be showing you how did I create this image from scratch using Photoshop. So if you like step-by-step process videos, I invite you to keep on watching. So the first thing is a solid background, and I start grabbing like random images. So I wanted to use this land here, this field. Like you see, I don't have this space, so I just duplicate it and I move it down. So if you zoom in, you can see the division of the pictures. So to avoid that, as you see here, what I do is like I create mask on everything that I want to start blending. At this point, you can start doing like some color corrections. Of course, it's going to be looking so weird because you don't have anything else. But then I start doing the main elements, like I said before. So the first element was the car. This is how the car looked at the beginning. I just mask the shape of the car and I start doing the shadows. So it looks like it's actually sitting on the land. See here. The second element that I decided to introduce was the main character. So it's Benny. As you see, I just remove his hand because he's pointing and I wanted to be grabbing a wand. So I use a second picture. So this was the original picture. This is my friend. I just cut the hand out of that picture and I start doing some color correction that I will be showing you after this. And the third element, of course, it was the wand itself. So now I have the whole character, the car. And I start thinking, well, what am I going to do with this? So I start doing the spell first. I had some references from Harry Potter, of course. So this is Spectro Patronum spell. And I need to start doing some lighting, some color correction, because like if you see this picture, you will notice that nothing looks like it's part of the same image. So that's the whole goal of this, is that everything needs to match color-wise and the lighting. And there was a fourth element that I decided to add at the end. It was a tree. So as you see, I have this tree here. So now we have the tree, the car, the person, and the spell. Then I start adding some lighting and some shadows. So I'm gonna start turning on those layers so you can see. I have these clouds here and I start color correcting them so they match with what I had before. And I start thinking, what can I do with this car? So I decided that I wanted to have a reflection of the light coming from the car, as you can see here. And don't worry, this is going to be looking better after. It's just, you need to start putting all the elements that you want to use and then you can fix it. Then I start adding some little clouds, some shadows, and some like galaxy looking things, like stars, little stars here. Then I added more shadows on the land, on the bottom part of the image, because it was too bright. And then I start going like to fix each element. So I start fixing the car first. So the first thing that I do is removing the plate number here because I wanted to make something different. I start fixing the color balance of the picture itself. And I start doing some shadows on this because it was too bright and it didn't have any depth. The second thing that I do here is that I want to add the 100K, like a little detail for Benny contest. And I start doing main color correction. That means that it will affect the whole picture, as you see here. So I start increasing the contrast. I start playing with levels and I start playing with curves. So the dark spots are darker and the light spots are lighter. But you can start playing with that. The second thing that I do is I start fixing the hand. So as you see, I start adding lights, shadows, color correcting this so it matches the actual color of the skin of Benny. It has to follow the light sources. So we have two light sources here. We have the spell and we have the car that I'm going to fix later. And as you see, I add another like main color correction. In this case, I'm adding hue and saturation to the whole image so it looks like less saturated. I start adding shadows to the shoes So it looks like he's actually standing up. As you see, this changed everything. And then I start adding shadows and lights to his body and to his jacket and to his clothes. And that's going to change the whole picture. Keep adding more lights. And I start playing with the how big the reflections are so they look natural. Another very important element was the fireflies. So I created only one firefly, and then I just duplicate them. The only difference is that the one that is like closer to the camera, if you will, I added some blur, so it looks like the depth is different, but they are actually the same element, it's just they have a blur. And I added a second layer of the same firefly so they look brighter. I keep adding light to this spell because it's really powerful, and the idea is that it looks like it's producing a lot of light. I start reducing the saturation of the tree, and I need to fix the contrast and the levels of that tree, and the lights coming from this spell are going to affect this tree as well. And another thing that is going to change the scene is I turn on the lights of the car, as you see. I turn on the lights and I made them even brighter, so you feel that the light is coming from that element. And I keep adding and playing with the levels of the whole scene, so everything starts blending together very well. So as you see, I added this character here that is the one that is fighting against Benny in this case. But that was not enough for me, so I decided to add a third one that is this character here that is the actual opponent to Benny. Last steps are mostly main color correction and playing with the curves and levels. So at the end, what I did is just I rendered the whole image, I add a blur that goes to the whole picture, and I try to mask it. So I just start removing the parts that I want to be super clear, and so it gives you some feeling of depth. And this is how I made my picture for Benny's contest. If you have any questions, just let me know, and I hope you liked it. See you in the next video.